Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times, and we're here today with Shadia Martini, who is running for state representative in the 54th district. How are you today?
Good, how are you?
Great. Thank you so much for being here. Can you just tell us what communities are in the 54th district?
The 54th includes five different communities. So I have half of Bloomfield Township, which is nine precincts, Bloomfield Hills, two precincts. I have almost all of Auburn Hills, except precinct four. All of Lake Orion, all 15 precincts, and two precincts from Oakland Township, the fifth and the seventh.
What made you decide to run for office?
When or where, why?
Why?
Why? Okay. So, I'm an immigrant. I was born and raised under dictatorship. And, when you grow up under a dictatorship, they really take your voice away. And this country gave me my voice back. And it's running for office is not really optional. It's something that I feel that I have to do. It's a debt that I feel that I have to pay back to this country. And this is why I'm running for office.
So, can you tell us a little bit about your professional background and the skills you bring to the table?
So I have a Bachelor's of Science in Architectural Engineering and an MBA from the University of Michigan in Ann Arbor with emphasis in real estate and finance. So I have worked as a teacher for 4 years at Aleppo University. And while I was teaching, I received a scholarship from the Austrian government to do research at the University of Economics and Business in Vienna. I spent a year there in their urban planning department. And from there, I came to the US. I went back to school, got my MBA, and I've been in real estate and construction since 1997. So I have this vast experience in construction, in real estate, in business. I'm a business. So I bring a lot of educational background and professional experience to the table. There's no one like me in Lansing today, someone with this diversity of experience, not only personal and professional, but also life experiences, because I lived on three different continents and I have seen, I lived under a dictatorship, I lived in Europe, I lived in this country. So I have this wealth of life experiences that I also bring to the table.
And what are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
So I have worked with refugees for years now. I'm also a proud Rotarian. I'm a member of Sunrise Rotary Club, Lake Orion. I do a lot of work on an international level and on a local level. So, on an international level, we work on expanding a hospital in Cartagena, Colombia. We also work on the local level. We have several programs. One of them is beds for children in need. So we provide the bed, the bedding, the mattress, everything, and we even go set it up for them.
What are some of the things that you'd like to work on if you are elected?
So there's so many things that I would like to work on. First and foremost is the economy. We have to work on improving the economy in Michigan. We have industry, we have agriculture, we have tourism, we have technology. We need to keep our kids in Michigan to bring more people into Michigan. I want to work on education, improve our public educational system. I want to work on the environment. We need to keep our water. I mean, we are the Great Lakes State. We need to keep our water and our environment in good shape. Clean drinking water is a priority. And I'm a housing expert. This is what I've been doing for so many years, and we have a housing crisis that we should work on. Women's rights to choose, reproductive rights, all these things are very important on my priority.
So in this race, there is some competition for the seat. Why should the voters pick you?
Well, Again, I'm a moderate Democrat, and our district is a very moderate district. So I'm a better fit for this district. I bring in my educational experience, my professional experience, my life experiences. Our district is very interested in keeping a woman's right to have a child through IVF. That's something that's very important that we need to keep and protect. Our district does not want to see what happened in Oxford and in Rochester Hills happen here. That's also very important, just sensible, reasonable safety measures. It's not taking guns away. That's not what I'm seeking. I am all for protecting the rights to bear arms, but I am also, along with all other reasonable gun owners, having certain sensible gun laws in effect. So that would include something like red flag laws, safe storage. We have passed many of these laws, but there's still more environment. I mean, we have to have clean water. We cannot allow what happened in Flint to happen again. And unfortunately, Flint is not the only city that suffers from contaminated water. We also PFAS issues. I mean, there's so many environment that we need to tackle. So I'm more of a fit for this district.
So if the voters want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
They can go to my website, votemartini.com. Very easy. Votemartini.com.
Perfect. Well, thank you for taking the time to do the interview with us today.
Thank you so much. Thanks for the opportunity.